Hello everybody, good evening. Today we are going to see about the detoxification part 2 session. Last week we have covered detoxification basics, why we have to do the detoxification, and we have seen three simple detoxification techniques: baric, enema and vegetable bath. But today we are going to see the one which is highlighted with the blue underline: turmeric smoke, eye wash, nose wash, pepper smoke, oil pulling, beans treatment, apple treatment, Surya Yoga and Dua Sleep. We will see in detail about each technique, how we can follow this and what is the benefit we are going to achieve with these techniques. And what are the items marked with the red color box, those are covered last session. So if you are attending this session first time, please watch the past video, which is available in the YouTube, so you can understand how to follow those three techniques. Today, we are going to see first detoxification technique is a turmeric smoke. Turmeric is very well known for this herbal value, mainly for fighting antibiotic, like natural antibiotic, and it fights with the germs very well. So how we are going to use it here? Mainly, this turmeric smoke technique is used to detoxify our respiratory system. That means the lungs will be detoxified with this one. What we have to do, we have to create a smoke. To create a smoke, we should not use the gas stove. Instead, we should use the ginger oil lamp. Like for puja, we used to lamp. The same we can use. Or in worst case, if we don't have the lamp, we can use the candle also. So we have to show this turmeric piece on this lamp. After a few seconds, it will start burn and we get smoke. So we have to take it to near to our nose and we have to inhale that smoke. And after a few tries, the smoke will go off. Then we have to show it to the flame. And again, we have to inhale it. So we have to repeat it multiple times. One important thing is that it will cause some burning sensation to the eyes. So when we are doing this practice, we should close your eyes. Otherwise, it will cause some irritation. And for the kids and small kids, it would be difficult to do it. So what we can do, we can do it when they are sleeping. So when they are sleeping, we can keep them in our lap. And we can hold on paper kind of funnel. We can make it like this. So something like this. And we at one end, we can show the smoke. And the other end, the smoke will, we have to keep it near to the kid's nose. So that the smoke will directly go to their nose. And some people will be having some sensitive skin. So if they feel some burning sensation, then it's better not to continue. So just we have to see if it is a simple sensation, it's okay. And if it is causing more burning sensation, it's better to stop it. We can do this turmeric smoke practice for approximately 4 to 5 minutes. And if someone is having cold or running nose, we can do it once a day, not more than that. And if you don't have any running nose or no cold, as a detoxification, if you want to practice, and as a prevention, if you want to do it, we can do it once a week. Okay, so these are the important of this this turmeric smoke practice. Let's go to the next one. Eye wash. Eye wash is mainly to give the chronic energy, the life force. The plain water will be having the life force. When we are doing the eye wash with the water, the chronic energy from water will be coming to our eyes. So eyes related issues like eyes irritation and any toxins accumulated in the eyes, all these things will be cleaned with this eye wash technique. And it will give refreshing our eyes. So what we have to do, we have to use plain water or mud pot water. We should not use the filtered RO water or boiled water. The main reason, when we boil the water or when we are filtering it, all the life energy will be going down. So if we are using that water to do the eye wash, then it will reduce the power of our eyes. Like it may cause some issues in the eyes. So it's always better to use the natural water, or we can keep the water in the mud pot for at least 12 hours something. So it will be having some value, then we can use that. So how we can do? There are multiple ways. One, we have the small cup, eye wash cup. We can fill it and we can keep it inside. We can keep our eyes inside that cup and we can keep blinking continuously. So this is one technique. Other technique, we can use a mug. We can fill the mug with water and we can keep our eyes inside that and we can blink. Other option is in the bathroom, we can fill the bucket and just we can keep our head inside that bucket and we can blink it multiple times. So these are the multiple ways we can do this eye wash. And the additional tip, nowadays we are spending too much time in front of the electronic gadgets like mobile, TV, laptop, computers, all these things. So because of which we get more eyes irritation. So one technique, we can use the eye wash. Another one is we can take wet cotton cloth, so we can make it wet with the plain water and we can keep it over eyes and we can take rest. So that is another simple way. Within 5 to 10 minutes, the eyes irritation will gone down. And we can do this eye wash practice daily 4 to 5 times. And in traditional treatment, in holistic approach, our eyes are linked with the liver. So when we are doing this practice, along with the purifying, detoxifying eyes, it will help to detoxify the liver also. So who's having the liver related problems, they also can do this one. And the next one is the nose wash. This one will be cleaning the path, the breathway from nose. It will go through the sinus and it will go the breathe pipe and through the throat. So in this way, whatever the toxins accumulated in the sinus path, in the breathway, this nose wash will be helpful to detoxify. So how to do this? This is, while looking at it, looks a little complex. So you can practice with a little water first time, then you can increase the water quantity. And whoever's having any sinusitis issue, they used to get a lot of pain and headache, they used to get it. So this will be best remedy for that. Within 5 minutes after doing this, they get they feel more comfortable from the sinus pain. So what we have to do, we have to take a little warm water, we should not boil it, warm water, and we have to add sea salt, little bit, very little bit, and we can filter that. After filtering that, we can use specific tool, the one which is mentioned in this photo you can refer, or we can use the normal mug also. So what we have to do, we have to bend our head like this, and first, before pouring water inside the nose, we have to start breathe out via our mouth. So our complete focus, mind focus will be on the breathe in, breathe out only. So how we have to tilt like this and we have to do. Once we start doing this after 10-15 seconds, our complete focus will be on the breathing. Then we have to start pour the water in the right nostrils. So once we do this, the water will come through this the nostril path and it will reach the throat and it will come out of the left nostrils. So we have to do this until first time you can start with maybe 100 ml and gradually you can increase it. Main issue is when we are pouring the water, we should not try to breathe through the nose. That is the only thing. So if we practice with the breathing with the mouth continuously, it will be very easy task. So once we complete it, just we have to sneeze it multiple times so that some mucus might be coming out. And after that, we have to change the direction. We have to repeat it in the opposite one, nose. So this way we can do it like once, and it will clean the nostrils, the along with the nostrils. If you have any nose blockage or any breathing issues, you can get very good relief after this one. And as a prevention, if you want to do it weekly once, we can do this practice. Next one is the pepper smoke. Pepper is also known as for very good herbal value. What we can do, we can take small needle or some hook, and we can just insert the pepper in that, and we can show it on the lamp, the sesame oil, ginger oil lamp. So in the photo I have taken from the Google, which was showing the gas stove, but it's not good to use the gas stove. And this is also to detoxify our lungs. It will settle the mucus, and it will come out slowly little bit. So it will be good practice to remove the toxins accumulated in our lungs. And when we are doing it, we can close our eyes, otherwise it may cause little irritation. So the same like turmeric smoke, when for the kids, small kids, if we want to do this, when they are sleeping, we can do this. And if you feel any irritation, mostly we won't feel any irritation. And if you feel irritation, we can stop it. And we can inhale through the mouth also. There's no issue with that. And we can do this for 5 minutes. Like after 1 minute, it might be fully burnt. So we can change the pepper. So we can use 4 or 5 peppers at a time. And if someone is having cold or running nose, we can follow this 2-3 times a day. Otherwise, as a prevention, we can do it like weekly 2 times or 3 times. That's good enough. And next one is the oil pulling. It's famously known for the lot of health benefits, because it not only detoxify our mouth, it also detoxify the toxins accumulated in the spleen. So as it is detoxifying the spleen, it is indirectly helping the digestion process. So this process, this oil pulling, helps for the detoxifying the whole body, because it will be along with the digestion, it will help to purify the blood also. How to do this? We should not use the refined oil. We should use always the virgin and non-processed oil only. For best result, sesame oil, that is ginger oil, can be used. Other option, we can use the coconut oil. We should do it on the empty stomach only. Empty stomach means after, in the morning when we wake up, it will be empty stomach. Like after, like in the morning, if you don't get the time, let's say if we are having the breakfast at 9 o'clock, after 2 hours, stomach will be considered as an empty stomach. So 11 o'clock, we can do the oil pulling. So this is the logic we can do. We can follow as per our convenience. What we have to do, first we have to take 2-3 spoons of oil, and we have to keep swishing it continuously. First time when you are doing it, we may feel a lot of pain because of we are doing this activity first time. So we have to keep it cold. We have to take a break, multiple break after a few minutes, and then we have to keep continue. Maybe first time, if you are doing it, do it for 5 minutes. And then after 2-3 iterations, we can increase to 7 minutes, 8 minutes, something like this. So after 1 week, we can reach 10 minutes very easily. So we have to take a break in between, and we have to do it for 10 to 15 minutes for the best result. And after we complete this swishing, we should not spit it on the garden area or any plant, because it will be having a lot of toxins. The plant will die because of the toxins in the from this one. So we have to spit this in the wash basin or in the toilet. That is the important note we have to follow. And the next one is the beans treatment. Beans treatment is well known for the kidney stones. It's a best remedy for the kidney stone. Also, it's a prevention for any kidney related issues. If we follow it, it will avoid forming the kidney stone. Or maybe when the kidney stone is at the small size, before we feel the pain, it will be helpful to break that kidney stones. how to do it? We have to buy like one quarter, like a quarter kg of beans, and we have to cut into small pieces, remove the seeds, boil in the water, 1 liter water, 1 or 2 liters water. We can boil it in the low flame for the long time. And then after that, let's say 30 minutes or 1 hour, we just, once it is cooled off, we have to grind it and drink it. After drinking that, next 3 hours, we should not eat anything. We should drink only plain water. 3 liters of water we have to drink for next 3 hours. So once, if someone is having the kidney stone, we can see when we are doing it, the kidney stone will come in the urine. And if for the biggest stone, it may not be coming in one cry. We may need to do it like daily once, like for 2-3 days. So after 2-3 days, it may come out. And for some people might be already very weak or very tired. So for them, it's better to do it once a week only, not to do it multiple times a week. And for the kids or very aged people, having this much quantity will be very heavy for them. So they can have it in the lesser quantity. So even though the result will be slower, it's okay for them because we should not overload them. So that was the reason we can go with the lesser quantity. And if someone is not having any kidney related issues, no kidney stones, as a prevention, as a detoxification, if we want to do it, we can do it once in 3 months. And in Tamil Nadu, when I gave this also as one suggestion for the kidney stone, one person was telling the another option, they tried it and it was working fine. So what they did, the raw the beans, they took it around 100 gram, just they made into small pieces and grind into juice and they filtered it and drink it. So after drinking it, they saw the stone, kidney stone was coming in the urine. So this is also another simple technique you can try. Apple treatment is might be very new for many of you. And if someone is having gallbladder stone, if we go to the hospital, treatment will be removal of the gallbladder. So it will be affecting our digestive system long-term, lifetime, full of lifetime will be affected. So this will be very, very simple technique, nothing, no risk at all, zero risk. And it will give very good result. Many people got benefited within 1 week, their stone got vanished. So what they have done, they just removed the skin and seed. And we have to eat it by chewing it very slowly. We should not eat it very fast. And for best result, there are many types of apple or that. Some apple used to be very hard. Some apple used to be very soft with the kind of, what we can say, it's very soft. If we just touch with his hand, just it will become as a paste, something like this. So that type of apple will be giving very good result. If you don't get it, you can take whatever the apple you have. If someone is having this gallbladder stone daily, morning and evening, we have to eat this, the apple, very slowly. Let's say even for one apple, 5 to 10 minutes, if you are taking, it's okay. So no hurry. We have to chew it very well and then we have to eat it. And if we don't have any stone, gallbladder stone, if we want to do it as a detoxification, as a prevention, monthly, once like 2-3 days continuously, we can follow it. So this is very simple and many people got followed and got recovered it without any surgery, without taking any medicine. Surya Yoga is another very simple technique. We don't need to spend anything. How to do is like our body generally, our body takes the energy via major from the food, water and air, breathing. This is the, in each of this way, food, water or air, it will be creating some toxins. In case of solid food, the motion will come. In case of water, urine will come. And in case of breathing, carbon dioxide will come. Surya Yoga is very simple technique. It does not create any toxins. Whatever the energy we are taking, that will be fully 100% utilized by our body. So how to do it? Very simple. we have to go to the open ground area, and we have to stand without any shoe, chappal, socks, nothing. We have to stand in the barefoot. Any soil or grass area is okay. We should not stand on the cement tiles or the tar road. So what we have to do, just we have to look at the sun directly. At what time? There is some specific time we have to do. In the morning, when the sunrise is happening, let's say my sunrise is happening at 6 o'clock. From 6 o'clock till 6:45, it's very suitable time. It will not harm, it will not do any harm to our eyes. If you do it later, it may cause harm to our eyes. So first 45 minutes from the sunrise and last 45 minutes just before sunset. So these two times we can do this technique. And what we have to do, we have to look at the sun without blinking it continuously. First time it may be difficult. You can try with maybe 10 seconds and then 15 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds. So gradually we can increase. So this is one simple and very best technique. We can do it daily, morning and evening. So you can try it, and many people got very good on the whole day. They feel more energetic after following it. If someone is wearing specs, cooling glass, nothing, we should not wear it. And for eye power recovery, this is one important technique. Duva sleep is kind of mostly till now we have seen about detoxifying our body, different organs. But Duva sleep is working differently. It will detoxify body, but not directly. It will detoxify the mind first. Many people might be having some sleep-related sleep disorder, not having the deep sleep because of which too much stress. And so there are psychological issues might be happening followed by lack of deep sleep. So for them, and some people might be feeling very tired, very weak. So for all those people, this Duva sleep will be very helpful. And to do this one, we need someone else's help. We cannot do it alone ourselves. A minimum one more people we need. If we have more people, it will be okay. So what we have to do? We have to choose some place like some room which is very calm and we have very good ventilation. And we have to lie down by facing up, that is supine position. And just we have to close our eyes, and another person, they have to keep their fingertip on top of our head, on the different, any area they can keep. They should not do any massage, any movement, just they have to touch, that's it. We should not feel any pain because of that. We should not feel that there is no one touching. So little sense is needed. So simple touch is enough. So we have to keep it like this for 10-15 minutes. And within short period, like 10-15 minutes, the person will go into the deep sleep. To get best result, we have to continue for more time. And maybe we can keep it like one hand, we can keep it for some time, 5-10 minutes. After that, we can keep another hand. Or we can take help of other person. So in this way, we can, if someone is very sick, very tired, very weak, we can follow it and they will get very good sleep. After next day morning or after they wake up, they will share the result. They feel very more energetic. And better, we should not avoid any pillow. Maybe if you need pillow, maybe very small, thin, soft pillow can be used. Before following it, we should not take heavy food. We should take very light food off stomach only. And there are simple rules we have to follow. If someone is pregnant or ladies during the menses, or someone is not feeling well during sickness, they should not give this Duva treatment to the other people. But they can get the treatment because this is completely working based on the life force energy flow. If one person is sick, so in his body, the energy level will be, life force energy will be less, and the healthy person will be having more energy. So by doing this, the person, the healthy person, will be giving his energy to the another person through his fingertips. So that helps the person to recover more, and they will, because of the deep sleep, their body will work automatically without any mind intervention. Okay, so these are the techniques we have covered today. So do you have any doubts? Okay, someone was asking the techniques what we have covered today. So we have covered these 9 techniques. And have anyone followed the techniques which we have explained last week? Vedic, enema, vegetable bath.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah.
Yes. Sir, I follow enema. It's very nice and feel very light in the stomach. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Thanks for the feedback.
Sir, one more doubt, sir.
Yes.
One more doubt, sir. For watching the sun in the first floor, we can watch in the upstairs, sir.
In the upstairs,
it will be good effect.
No, it will not give that much effect. The main reason, we should connect our body from sun to the earth. So the energy flow will go through from through ice to the ground. So it's kind of electricity pass. We can imagine how the electricity will pass through the wired line. So when we pass it, when the sun energy pass through this way, so we get more energy in the body.
Okay, sir, fine.
In worst case,
okay,
you can
sir.
Do that,
thank
but
you.
That will give very less benefit only.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Vedic, already I have explained in the last week's session. In our stomach intestine, we can see that video in the YouTube.
Hello.
Yes,
sir. Good evening. Good evening, sir. This is Parthivan from Coimbatore.
Yes.
Yes, sir. In detoxification, I get salt water in the stomach, sir, and I got vomited.
Okay.
One time I got like yellowish water is liquid coming outside.
Yes.
I found that one.
Yes.
After 1 week again I done, sir.
Yes.
That time only light water came, not so much of water came from the stomach, sir.
Yes. The main reason, the lot of pittam accumulated in our stomach. So when you are doing it first time, that came out. So when we are doing it after 1 week, within the short period, it may not be accumulated more. So because of that reason, it was not coming out. Okay. So maybe,
sir, okay.
If you are doing it after 2 months, you may see that yellow color liquid again.
Okay, the second time I done, the water also not came, sir.
Okay. Maybe was not coming. Motion was not coming.
Water also not came, sir.
Okay, vomit was not coming.
Yeah, sir. Second time I done.
Okay.
Only liter water came, sir. I drank almost 1 liter, but very minimum water came outside this.
Okay, in the motion or vomit?
Vomit, sir. Vomit.
Vomit. Okay. So nothing to worry. It's it might have passed the water to the intestine area. So that was the reason it might not have come. And your stomach might have been already clean because of already you have done this practice. So because of which it is not required to retain the water in the stomach.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Sir, I took some time, sir. If you drank that water, warm water with salt, we should suddenly get vomited, or we can take some time.
It may take some time. At least some people used to get it like after half an hour sometime. Nothing to worry.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. It's very useful information given by you by lot of time, and you have done very nice job in this pandemic time, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Okay, thank you all for the joining the session. Let's live healthy. Let's make this world healthy. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.